Thank you. How long have you been working on this, Raymond?
Oh, all in all,
what's it for? Yeah, what's it for, Raymond?
It's called the first time. It's a commemoration of the first time today. Visual is based on that photograph of the boy kind of baby child.
Is this a commission?
Yeah.
For what?
For who?
For who and for what?
I just said, it's the commemorate that whole incident. And it's commissioned by one
end. Well, where will it be going?
Max Roach Park, Brixton.
When do you hope to finish this?
We finish by the middle of May. The unveiling is in the middle of June. And it should be finished by the middle of May.
Thank you. What are you working out there?
I was filling in some spaces I need the hand actually. And tying it into the fingers. We're basically running some tendons from the wrist through the knuckles into the fingers. To make the bottom part.
Thank you.
Why do you work in steel, Raymond?
I can help back, but this is linear. It's there. I can feel with the line as much as the rest of the I can reach. And I think that's what I work in. I don't carve anymore. First market for this is the second one.
So show me the first one.
Okay. Yeah, this is the first three-dimensional market for the whole concept. Working with various components, scale and how I approach it.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the first three-dimensional market. After the jar and work on the basically it's just to work out the scale and various components, how I would approach it and so forth and so on. And then the composition too. There are tips.
How long did it take you to compose everything before you started on the main one? But you're used to big pieces, aren't you?
Yeah, I guess I am. Most of my designs are designed with the notion of making big life size. So I guess I am a person.
What made you choose this particular subject?
This is part of the commission. I was essentially stuck with the whole concept from that, from beginning.
So who brought this concept to you?
My name is okay. Commission.
And they decided that they wanted
they
that?
They decided they wanted based, visually based around
this image.
This photograph. Okay. And, so I just used the three main figures in the photograph. From there. Jamaica is a lot harder to sell out now than it was.
During that period.
Yeah, than it was. And I don't know. But then again, there's another side to it, which is really where I plan to be going, which I need some money for. Basically, what I'm going to do is start reproducing the drawings and the two-dimensional stuff off like that and leave the sculpture. I'm not even going to worry about the sculpture because too difficult, too much. Evidently, I disturb people.
Your images.
My work disturbs people, evidently. And so I've run into so much kind of negative kind of thing. I did a little, you know, it's really deep and heavy, you know, but the usual argument. But people out there are not going to understand that. So which people out there are not going to understand that? What are you trying to tell me? So it's a pure assholes out there. I mean, all of these people out there are just idiots and can't understand. Well, maybe you should fill it in. I said, to what? I said, no. And so this went on for a couple of days. And I said, I'm not filling it in. I'm not changing the whole situation. I've made the statement. And if you don't like the statement, well, that's it. I can't. Same battles. That one outside the front there. I did that.
The figure. Sitting there.
Seated figure. I did that. That's called Naked Cayman. I did that for the Side Institute in 1982. 82, 83, somewhere. And they rejected it. Well, the last story I heard is one woman on the board decided that she ain't walking past this naked man to go to work every morning. Guy was supposed to be right in front of the entrance.
Right, it was supposed to scale it up.
Eh? That, no, no, that is that
that's the size.
That's the size, yes.
Okay.
And that's the first, that's the first dance piece I've done.
Okay.
Out of school, that one there. I did one in school, but they stole that one. They've been at me for a long time. Mexico, they don't come back. But you know what really, what living in London really taught me though?
What is that?
That my work is very heavily tied to Jamaica.
Oh yes.
No matter where I go, how far away it is, how ridiculous it gets, my work is really sickly religious. And we ignore the philosophy of religion.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
All we really deal with is the superstition and the ceremony.
Yeah,
superstition and the ceremony. That's all we deal with.
Yeah.
And if I start to talk, people think I'm a heathen.
This is a series on
where based on the country, largely.
Well, like the silk cotton.
Yeah. But it started with brown ice and the country and the rock.
Okay.
Which you can't see right now, it's kind of in storage because they stole my sculpture the other day. Yes. Well, I'm into stealing metal nowadays.
Alright, because I saw.
Steel, so they ripped it off and it disappeared. 2 years worth of work and behind that kind of situation. Pretty much is one of a couple of the things that I've been playing situation. And that's basically the story behind that.
So where is that destined for now?
I don't know, it's not for somebody who will buy it. It has a buyer out there.
Somewhere,
I'm an artist, I'm ridiculous, I have faith. It has a buyer out there. I know it has a buyer out there. The buyer just hasn't seen it yet, maybe. But, that is how it goes. But anyway, I start with the country, with the kind of, where it was a, actually, if you might have seen it at the gallery, this kind of female figure with the arms stretched out. And I was kind of playing with the contradiction of the upward thrust of the upper body and the kind of rooted notion of the lower body.
Hello.
And that went in two different directions. It went into the country kind of direction. Which I hear there's some really crazy stuff too, like you go to England and you have somewhere to sleep and you have £200 and you spend £120. No, paying rent. So next month you want to know what you're about paying. And it goes and you just do this because you need a space, you need a studio, so you get a studio and you work it out. You know? This is absolute insanity. Serious. It's no joke. He will confirm.
Yeah.
So will you.